10 hours, 20 minutes to go. So, in that time, at that time, you might have plans to do something else and now suddenly think, oh, there's the match. We might be missing this. How are we going to get around this? Do we change our plans? Do we drop plans? Is there a compromise available?
Yeah, and that works for entertainers as well. It's Saturday night. They could be doing a gig just like Paul Heaton from the beautiful South. Morning, Paul.
Morning.
How you doing? I understand this evening you've got a gig on and you're messing around. Well, how's it working? What are you going to do?
Well, firstly, we're playing in Manchester Arena tonight, and I did point out to management a few weeks ago that this could clash with the England match. But what we've decided to do is show the game, but in the concourse, put on alternative entertainment. So the Billy Bragg will be on at 6. No. He's not on at 7. And then we go on at 9. Hopefully it'll be over by then. And between 7 and 9 on the concourse, there'll be free mulled wine, a brass band playing carols, a band called Before Breakfast, and also a band called Uncle Frank, and then carols near the end of the match.
Okay. So, Paul, does this mean that it becomes a longer night for you? Not that anyone's going to complain, but you kind of got this bit in the middle, haven't you now? Kind of a football match.
It's a longer night for people who will get there for Billy Bragg, but if you're only going to get there in time for the match, it's the same length, really, 7 till around about 10:45. So, I was wary of turning it into an evening of football. So I just wanted to put something on for those who didn't want, because there is a lot of people probably watching this now who are a little bit sick of football. There's people who aren't into the game, or maybe have had too much of it. Or people who don't want to watch England, for example.
Yeah,
so it was just that.
It's a good point. It's a good point. Which camp do you sit in? I mean, what will you be doing as the match is on?
I'll be watching through gritted teeth, but I won't tell you who I want to win, otherwise people wouldn't buy my records anymore. But no, I'll be sat with the band enjoying the match, and also going through to the concourse and checking everything. It's impossible for me to really get involved in football because with Jackie not being on the tour, I've got to really look after my throat. So throwing compliments or insults at the football screen just an hour or so before I go on stage isn't a good idea. So I'll be keeping quiet but watching intently.
Paul, just now, you've done lots and lots of gigs over the years. The idea of coming on and doing a performance if England have because it could happen, England could lose, and in terms of an atmosphere, that's not great, is it? I mean, it's maybe not exactly what you want.
No, but I would say, in fairness, to the age of my audience, they have seen England lose before. That's what I would say. Most of them are in their 40s and 50s, perhaps a little bit younger than me, and it's not going to be the first time they've lost. Plus, I think there's genuinely an optimism in this camp and goodwill towards the players. I cannot imagine a evening where Southgate and his players would have let England down. I think that would be the... I think that would lead to a sort of slightly, I would say, sour atmosphere, but, you know, a bit of despondency. I think going by the performances so far, I think most people, even if it was a narrow loss, would be in an okay mood.
How's Jackie? Because she's got voice problems, hasn't she?
She has. She did the first three concerts with us and then noticed her voice wasn't right and had a bit of a sore throat, and she's now seen a doctor. She's been seeing a doctor throughout, but saw a specialist yesterday morning who's advised her to rest for 6 weeks he's had a proper look at, I won't go into the full details, but he's had a proper look at her throat and a prognosis, and she has to rest and get herself better.
We obviously send her our best. It wasn't so long before you, so long ago, that you two were joining us, Charlie and I, on the sofa, and we were having a good old chat. How's the show going to be different in terms of that? Because, you know, people love Jackie's voice. We always talk about how beautiful her voice is.
They do. She's got a great voice, a great stage presence, and it's been very difficult to replace her. But we've got a couple of lads in the band who were very, very happy to try and replace parts here and there. And we've just played the songs, and I've sung Rotterdam and a couple of the others, and Pete, the drummer, and Chris, the bassist, and Johnny, the guitarist, have covered different parts. So it is less of a thing, you know, less of the songs do miss her, but the audience are happy to see people try and replace her and have a little go. And it's been great, but you know, that's not to underplay Jackie's involvement normally.
Paul, you've got a long day ahead of you with the gig tonight. Have we woken you up unusually early? Were you up anyway? Have you got up especially for us?
I have got up especially for you. I'm the sort of person who puts the telly on and watches you through one eye, and if there's something I fancy watching, I'll watch it. So I normally get up early anyway because I've got three young daughters, but on tour I tend to have a slightly later night and a later morning. So I would say I'd be probably getting up around about now, going down for breakfast and then heading over to Manchester in a couple of hours.
Well, do you know what I take from that? I take that as a beautiful South, absolute 100% endorsement of BBC Breakfast, because it just...
Absolutely, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, I always have you on. I miss you when I'm not in the studio, so I put you on in the hotel room instead.
Well, do you know what? I think we've got more time for this interview all of a sudden. It's just we've got... It's suddenly Paul can have as much time as he wants. Good luck tonight. I hope it all goes really well.
Thank you so much.
And there'll
be lots
of people who are really grateful that you've kind of taken the time to rearrange stuff to try to think of everyone. So thanks, Paul.
Yeah.
Okay. Take care.
And also, it's very true what Paul is saying. And I think it's worth saying, we are mindful in our coverage of the, you know, there are people for whom England against France and the football in the World Cup is not the biggest thing in the world.
No.
Today it is leading our bulletins because the game is tonight. But it's absolutely right what Paul says. You know, for some people it's not, that, you know, they're not, their day is not set around that. So we try and take that into account as well.
It's 13 minutes to nine. The Operations Centre at the East of England Ambulance Service deals with more than 3,000 calls a day.